Fellow Fright Fiends, it's your buddy Boogeyman Ben here for another episode of Boogeyman Ben's Horror Zone, and I want to say happy Friday the 13th to everyone. This is the only Friday the 13th we're getting in 2016, and for me, with the year that I've had and all the craziness that I've had, this is like the most normal thing for me this year. And for some reason, this series just means so much to me. I think a lot of the reasons why it means so much to me is that it's a part of my childhood. I grew up on these films. They were films that really brought me into just gore effects, and the gore was in the films, Tom Savini's effects, and just the makeup that was used to create Jason, and all of the impressively brutal kills throughout the series. I got interested in Fangoria because of the Friday the 13th films. I wanted to see how they did it. You know, it was almost like a magic show to me. It was like, I was scared of it at first, but it was something that I learned was fake, and then I was just fascinated by how they pulled off that effect. So this series to me, Adam Green, who does, he did the movie Hatchet, and he has the Movie Crypt podcast, he once said that Halloween was like his chicken soup, that it was a movie that he could just put on, and it was almost like, it relaxed him. And it's funny when you tell people that there's a movie series about a mask-wearing psychopath that's killing people, but that it's a comfort. The Friday the 13th series to me is a comfort. It's my favorite horror film series. It always has been my favorite horror film series. I'm very disappointed that we're not getting a new film anytime soon. I mean, they've still are saying January of next year, but what was supposed to happen is on this date, the new film was supposed to come out. So it's sad that we're not getting a new film. We are getting a video game. The video game is supposed to be coming out this fall. Last I checked, it was October, but with everything that's been going on in my life, I haven't really checked to see if that date is still standing. There's actually some great stuff that's actually going on sale today, later today. Cavity Colors has an amazing amazing poster and a patch and a brand new t-shirt. I think they have tank tops, t-shirts, and baseball tees. I'll put a link down to that below. Also, Fright Rags. Now, they started this last night. They started their Midnight Madness for Friday the 13th. And I'll put a link down to that below. Now, remember, that shirt is only going to be available for 24 hours. Same thing with the Cavity Colors. They said that once it's sold out, it's sold out. There's actually another site called Terror Threads, which I haven't really been into, that they're actually doing some special Friday the 13th shirts as well that are going to be limited. And I'll put links down to that one below. And Sideshow has actually put out I don't think they've done the pre-orders yet, but they're they're going to be re-releasing some of their earlier figures. They're going to be re-releasing Friday the 13th Part 3, the Jason look from that. That was their first sideshow figure that they did of Jason. Also, we got some more Jason collectibles that are going to be coming out soon. Very similar to the premium Friday the 13th Part 6 Jason Lives figure. They're doing a Part 3 one. That's supposed to be coming out this summer. They're also bringing out a Roy from Friday the 13th Part 5. They're bringing out a mask, the hockey mask from that film. So yeah, I just can't say enough great things about Friday the 13th, and this series means so much to me, and like I said, it's a almost like a time capsule to my youth and how much these films meant to me growing up, and you know, what they became. You know, I mean, I never in a million years dreamed that there would be Jason toys and, you know, video games and comic book series and t-shirts like the one I'm wearing. I mean, there's so much Jason stuff that's out there now. When I was a kid, I would have drooled over this stuff. I mean, it would have been so awesome if they had stuff like this when I was a kid. They didn't have anything like this when I was a kid. So I'm kind of feeling like I have, it's almost like an extension of my youth. And like this room and all of the stuff that I love and collect, you know, it's because I loved it as a kid. This series, I just love this series more and more every year. And I'm so hoping that we will get a 13th chapter soon. I'm not holding my breath right now. I'm assuming they'll probably push out the date again, because they haven't even started casting it and we're already halfway through this year. It would be great if we got another Friday the 13th film pretty soon. I mean, if people don't realize it, but we're getting close to almost, I mean, it's been over 7 years since the last one came out. So it's like, it's time. Jason needs to come back to the big screen. And, thank God for companies like Fright Rags and Terror Threads and Cavity Colors and NECA. And all of these companies that are putting out, in Funko, that are putting out these great Jason products. It'll keep the character alive in between waiting for another Friday the 13th film. And like I said, in the year of craziness that I've had, this, you know, this day to me is just sort of a little bit of normalcy. You know, the year's getting much, much better, much happier than I was. Yeah, it's been a very different year, very difficult year, lots of change, and I'm glad that this is the one thing that remains the same, and I have this one day that everybody thinks is weird that I celebrate. I just wanted to say happy Friday the 13th to all of my fellow fiends. And one thing I also want to bring up is that my buddy Jason from Beyond the Realms, he is doing a Periscope, live Periscope, 10 o'clock Eastern. And he is going to be doing a commentary on Friday the 13th Part 6, Jason Lives, and Friday the 13th Part 7, The New Blood. It's going to be fucking awesome. He does some terrific commentaries. I've tried to take part in all the ones that he's done, but this is just so close to my heart. I can't wait to attend this and be a part of it. And I invite all of you to check it out as well. I'll put the information down below where you guys can check it out. Jason's a great guy, and I can't wait for this commentary of especially Part 6, which is my favorite Friday the 13th film of all time. And Part 7 has really grown on me, and I'm a huge fan of that one now. But Part 6 has been my favorite since I saw it 30 years ago, this coming summer, when I was 12 years old. And one thing I am planning on doing is I'm probably going to be doing a 30th anniversary video on Friday the 13th Part 6. There's a couple other films I'm going to be doing that on as well, but I'm really looking forward to doing that one as well, because there's a few films that came out in 1986 that are hugely part of my life and mean so much to me. But that's going to be about it. So I want to thank everyone for watching this video. Hope everyone has a great Friday the 13th. And I will talk to you guys later. Take it easy. Stay scared. Peace.